काली कुच समायुक्त माया कूडोपदेशतः प्रणवार्थ प्रबोधिन्यौ नमामि गुरुपादिके श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः क्रीम मात्रे नमः नमस्सदसे गुड इवनिंग टू वन एंड ऑल आर सेकंड गुड इवनिंग टू वन एंड ऑल टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक अबाउट वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक वन इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन दैट मेनी पीपल हैव आस्क्ड अबाउट नित्यानंदास डिसाइपल्स दैट इज व्हाई डू नित्यानंदास डिसाइपल्स लाई सो मच. This is a basic normal question. Second level of the question is, and how do they justify it to themselves? That is the bigger question. Now, from the very starting point, the very first case of Vinay Bharadwaj, as far as I know, that is the first allegation from Nithyananda Sangha towards an ex-disciple. So from the very first case of Vinay Bharadwaj, all the way till the so-called gurukul kids being abused, in Gujarat, the case raised against 16 people, including child welfare officials and police, Gujarat police. We see that people are lying so much. And these are blatant lies because of two reasons. One is, it does not make any sense objectively. That is the reason why none of these cases are sticking in the court. Not even one allegation that Nithyananda has made against anybody has stuck so far in the court. It is only wasting the time of the court and it is only making the lives of those who are being accused horrible. That is all it is achieving, and I think that itself he considers as a success because he is a perverted idiot. You can fill that word idiot with any bad word that you want. I am sitting in front of Ambal, so I will not say. So, now, second thing is, the persons who are making these statements subjectively know that it is not true because it did not happen to them. So how do they, you know, balance it within themselves? How do they convince themselves? What is the process that is going on? This is what we are going to discuss in this video. So there are four steps in culturing or in cultivating a cult follower into doing this. The first step is to create a sense of, the first step is to create a victim complex. And the second step is to create a doomsday scenario. And the third step is to create a sense of martyrdom. And the fourth step is to create an amoral situation, an amoral mindset. So let us see what are these four steps, one by one in detail. The first one, victim complex, is an idea that everybody is attacking you. The whole world is against you. And Nithyananda is achieving this. Nithyananda is achieving this by, doing something very simple. He is saying, we are the only ones who are telling the truth and the world does not want to accept it. So we are being attacked from everywhere. We are the victims. So this is the victim complex. We also know that he has been screaming about so many murder attempts against him, so much of poisoning, this and that. We do not know whether his broken mind has caused this or he is simply acting to gain sympathy, because it is a combination of the two. And I think he himself does not know where the acting stops and where the real paranoia is starting. I think I mispronounced the word. Paranoia or paranoia. P-A-R-O-N-I-A. Okay, is starting. So, he himself does not know. An evil enemy is created by the organization. And in this case, the evil enemy is anybody who is speaking against the organization or who is working against the organization, who has come out of the organization, and that person is an anti-Hindu. And Nithyananda had the gall to call, he had the guts to call Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, RSS, as an anti-Hindu, anti-Guru organization. The Akhila Bharatiya Akkada Parishit is one of the subsidiary or associated organizations of the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh. And any Sampradayik Guru who is involving himself in any social cause is being supported by the RSS. And they are doing the real revival of Hinduism in India and all over the world. Everybody knows this, and he has the balls to call RSS as an anti-Hindu organization. And there is a reason behind that. I don't want to go into that because that is some insider information. If the need be, I will speak about it in later videos. And one more thing is, once this situation is created, the immediate reaction from his disciples and his slaves will be, we will not be trampled upon, we will survive. So this mindset is called as the victim scenario. And the result of the victim complex is that, they will say, we will do whatever it takes to come out of the situation. So that kind of agreement, that kind of acceptance is created in the mind of the cult follower. And then the second step is the doomsday scenario. It is like saying, we will be completely destroyed. If this happens, or if this threat is not contained, or this is the beginning of the landslide for our organization and our message. So this he has stated so many times, and even after the very first scandal, this Krishna is not having Arjuna, and that incident, like when his foreign disciples, when disciples from abroad, they came and joined him during the Kumbh Mela, those things. And now he is calling those very same Kumbh Mela people as druggies, racists, so on and so forth. Because I think the majority of the foreign disciples who are currently speaking against Nithyananda belong to this group, belong to the people who came at that time, including Sarah Landry and others. And the second thing is, in Nithyananda's organization, a very present and current sense of doomsday is created. Thereby, every attempt of anybody to expose him becomes a doomsday scenario. So in this doomsday scenario, what will happen to the devotee or the slave, cult follower, will be, he'll be like, oh my God, I have to stop this. I will do anything to stop this. So first there is acceptance, wherein he is saying, I will not be trampled upon, I will come out of it. Second thing, I will stop it at any cost. So this is leading directly into the third one, that is creating a sense of martyrdom. So that is the core of his current talks. He is speaking about Tyaga, Rudrakanya system, Abad Sanyasa, all of these things, saying anything can be done, even dying or killing is okay for the Dharma. Now, both, as you may have guessed, is total nonsense, and it is useful only as tools for conditioning the cult follower to think that he is a martyr by doing some damage to himself. That is, if you are lying that you have been abused, you have been raped as a woman, you feel great because you are a martyr for the cause. And the more damage you do to yourself, the more is your sense of elation when this sense of martyrdom enters into you. And now, this is very simple logic and very simple psychology. That is, we all have this tendency. We normally have this tendency. Everybody would have complained like this. I am doing so much for my family, but I am not getting proper respect from my family. Or I am doing so much for I am sacrificing so much for my girlfriend or my boyfriend, but they are not recognizing it. Or I am the only person who is doing so much of work in my workplace, but I am not being recognized. I am the last person to be recognized. These kinds of things, every one of us would have normally told at least once in our lives. So this is the sense of martyrdom, which we are craving for inside us, which we normally have. And usually, the cult victims, those who are very active inside a cult, those who are doing so much for a cult, are usually people with low self-esteem and conformity issues. They find this conformity, they find this acceptance inside the cult, because they are actively looking for these kinds of people. For example, I am a normal human being. If I want to befriend somebody, if I want to join a group, I will simply go and mingle with everybody. I will speak with everybody. I will open a conversation. But a person with low self-esteem will not be able to open this conversation. And inside the cult, everybody will be opening conversations with them. Everybody will try to befriend them. It is called love bombing. If you are continuously watching Nithyananda cult survivor videos, you will know what is love bombing. If not, please go and watch videos of Sarah Landry and Chris Shelton. You will understand what is love bombing. Now, what is happening is, due to this love bombing, people with low self-esteem are the ones who go too deep into the cult. And with a sense of martyrdom, they are willing to do anything. And the more damage they are causing for themselves, the more elated they feel, because they think they have contributed more towards the cause. So that is the third step in this operation. And the fourth step is to create an amoral scenario. An amoral scenario is a situation in which there is no right and wrong. You can do whatever the situation demands. This is an extreme situation. This is an extreme scenario. And Nithyananda is quoting things like, you know, Arjuna killed so many people in the war. Even Rama was hiding behind the tree and he was killing Bali. All of these examples. There are so many examples that you can give from the Itihasas and the Puranas. Now the problem is, they did it for Dharma. And end of the day, the person who did that did not get affected. The opposite party got affected. Three things happened. First thing is, they did it for Dharma. And there is no Dharma with Nithyananda. There is only Adharma with him. Either absence of Dharma or active presence of evil. These are the only two things that he has. So nothing is happening for the sake of Dharma inside Nithyananda's organization. Whatever else they might claim. Everything is centered upon himself. Every practice is centered upon himself. And he is actually attaching, he is actually, bonding his disciples more and more to him. Even sadhana is actively discouraged inside the organization. This is a complete God complex megalomaniac scenario wherein people will not benefit from this. They will only be victimized and they will only be damaged. Physically, emotionally, mentally, energy level. Everywhere damage will happen because of what he is doing. So it is not for the Dharma. Second point is, at the end of the day, the persons who are doing this kind of action are not the ones who are affected if you are doing it for the Dharma. But in case of Nithyananda slaves, in case of Nithyananda cult followers, the problem is they are the ones who are affected at the end of the day. They are damaged and their family is damaged. So this is what is exactly happening. And the opposite party is only affected in the sense of handling a case in the court. His life is damaged only in that sense. None of the allegations have stuck so far in the court. What is your answer for this? So you are creating a mindset of victimhood. You are creating a mindset of doomsday. You are creating a mindset of amoral situation and martyrdom. So with these combinations, anybody can be convinced to lie through their teeth, whatever is required for the organization. This is exactly what is the evangelical mindset. And in yesterday's shiksang, I don't want to call it satsang, asatsang. Okay, in yesterday's asatsang, what happened was, he was telling 10% is acceptable because it is the dasamabhaga. That is the traditional payment for the guru. Where is this coming from? What are you blabbering? This was supposed to be a part of the last video. I am including in this video. Because you know I am very, very unorganized. So forgive me. So he is saying, speaking about dasamabhaga. What is dasamabhaga? Dasamabhaga is the 1/10 tithe that you have to pay towards the church in Christianity. That is called dasamabhaga in India, in Tamil Nadu. Dasamabhaga is a word that is there in the Tamil Bible, which means the 1/10 of the tithe, 1/10 tithe, 1/10 of your income that you are paying towards the church. So he is telling dasamabhaga is accepted in Hinduism as the traditional payment to the guru. Where the hell are you getting this from? First you said Vedagama, now you are saying dasamabhaga. I understand you are an Hallelujah guy. And that being the Hallelujah guy, being a Christian evangelical missionary, who is working for money, also fits this bill, because this one also doing anything, saying anything for the purpose of spreading Christianity, that is also another principle that they follow, which is actually against Christianity and against Christ, as far as I can understand the religion. They are spoiling the name of Christianity by doing this. And here, Nithyananda is also doing the same thing. He is saying you can lie, you can do whatever you want to enrich people. You can torture them, you can call them again and again and again. Okay, and you can extort money from them because the Sangha needs money. And you can destroy anybody out there. All this nonsense is happening. And he is always moving the goalpost. Now, for no other reason, this Paramashivoham 2 has been started. Other than to say that whatever practices, high level practices you have done so far is invalid. Now I am going to give you the real practices, so pay me more money. So when anybody is coming against this, you know, prosperity gospel, and when anybody is speaking against this money making scam, he is accusing them using the disciples who are otherwise normal people. I have even heard that some of his disciples who are very, very abusive today were very sweet people some years back by those who have associated with them. They have told that some of the ex-disciples who spoke to me, they said that, oh, this person is being so abusive today, but he is actually a very nice person this many years back. So he is creating amoral monsters, amoral lying monsters by his mind manipulation and using cult technology. That is exactly what is happening inside the Nithyananda organization. And that is exactly how all the liars inside the organization, all the accusers from the organization are comfortable lying about the most horrible things possible. This includes Janardhan Sharmaji's daughters. This includes the very first person who filed a case against, Vinay Bharadwaj, all the way to the Gurukul kids who have filed cases right now against the Gujarat government officials and child welfare officials. Even this case is not going to stand in the court. So I see that he is only going from a bigger mess to a bigger mess every time there is a problem for him, because he is not using his brain to think. He is using his ego to just act out whatever he wants. He has got eternal dreams of success, and he believes in those dreams, which is exactly what is megalomania and God complex in psychology. And that tendency is also permeating, is also percolating the minds of his disciples. So this complex scenario of damage, hatred and abuse can only be broken if the organization is brought to a standstill and if the people are stopped from listening to him, both online and offline. This can effectively happen if Indian government is taking sufficient action after the March 27th hearing to stop his organization and to stop his satsangs from being broadcasted by getting the red corner notice against him. I fervently pray to Kali that these things should happen. That being said, I will end this medium-sized video, which is usually shorter than what I do, and hopefully I will take up some topic and speak on another scripture which Nithyananda has messed up very soon, as usual in my long pattern videos. Thank you for listening, and please share, subscribe, and like, share and subscribe. Yeah, like, share and subscribe. Okay, do that. Thank you. Pracham yora vrinimahe gatum yajnaya gatum yajnapataye dhaivi swastirastunaha swastir manushebhyaha urdvam jigatu veshajam Channo astu dvipate e sanchatushpate aum shanti 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 hi. Namaste.